In this lecture, we will explore the display property of CSS. Okay. In previous lecture, we have seen how to write the CSS, different ways to write the CSS, external, internal, and inline CSS. Okay. So in this lecture, we will focus on the display property of CSS. Now, what exactly the display property is? Suppose we have this h1 tag here, okay. We have the heading inside a body. Now we are using the internal CSS here. I am writing the selector here. And if I write the display as none, this display is a property, this is a value, okay. This is a property, this is a value. This is a selector. H1 is a selector. This is a property, this is a value. Now, if I apply the value as none to the display property, the heading is gone. It is not visible anymore. If I write a block, the heading will be visible. So, display property is used to hide and show the elements on the web page. So, similarly, if you have a paragraph also, you can use display as none. So the paragraph is gone. If you use the display as block, the paragraph will come. So this is the purpose of display property. Okay. Now display inline list 3. Suppose we have a list here. Okay. This is a list here. Now if we apply a property display as none, so the list will be gone here. Okay. If we display the block, it will display the block. Now if we display the inline, so it will bring all the list items to the one line. All the list 1, list 2, list 3 are coming in the single line. Here if you apply a padding here of 20 pixels, so padding is used for adding the spacing. And if I also give the background as red here, so the padding is used to add the spacing from all the sides, from left, from top, from bottom, from right. Okay, so here the padding is applied, and the display inline is bringing all the elements in a single line. If we use a block here, it will add a break. It will bring second item on the next line and third on the next line. Similarly, if I add one more item here like list 4, it will come here. If we use inline, all the items will come in a single line. Okay, so this is the purpose of display property. Okay, there are more values for display property like flex. So we will see those things in future lectures, but for today's purpose we have keep the things as basic for display none, display block, and display inline. Okay.